I would like to say that financial management is a case-to-case basis. The content of this video is not a Bible truth about financial literacy, but at least will challenge some of your mindsets to make a difference in your life and make important decisions on how you can bring about that change. They say financial literacy is only for the rich because they will argue that the poor would hardly be able to have money enough for their needs, how much more they could save and manage the money that they actually lack. Wrong. Because the poorer the person is, the more that person should become educated on how to manage the finances well. Again, financial literacy has nothing to do with how much money you make, but it is how you manage that money to make your life better. Here are 10 simple tips on how you can improve your thinking relative to what you call money. Some of these may just be what you need to become richer, not only in money, but in essence of living. The first thing you have to do is to record the dynamics of the money that comes in and comes out. You should be able to ask at least 3 important questions. Number 1, where did it come from and where will it go? Second is, how did it come in and how will it come out? And the third is, why did it come in and why did it come out? In so doing, you can justify to yourself why you need to spend on something. The problem with others is that their expenses will always be higher than their income. And simple math will tell us that it will lead to the negative. The second suggestion that I have for you is to make sure that you can create your passive income. Passive income refers to income that you don't have to be actively engaged in or directly working for it. There are so many financial portfolio. You can check with your financial advisors, you can go to banks and other financial institutions, because small money that you put there could actually earn without you having to work for it. Aside from the regular income that you have from salary, business, and other means of incomes, maybe you may want to explore other avenues for you to earn from these different sources outside your comfort zone. And this can come in forms of investment. My second tip has something to do with increasing the sources of money that comes to you. And in most cases, you would realize that money may come to you in big amount, but you still feel inadequate, that it is sufficient to spend for what you feel are your needs. He who buys what he does not need actually steals from himself. And number 3 has something to do with how you spend your money. Do you know the difference between needs and wants? A need is something so important and essential, which if you don't get, you'll probably die. Like food, water, shelter, clothing. But you would notice that a big portion of your spending has something to do with wants. Things that you thought you cannot live without, but in fact, you simply desire to have. For example, yes, you need a mobile phone to communicate, because nowadays, a mobile phone is an essential to communication. Why should it be the model that you want, which is way far from what you can actually afford? But what will you do for those things that you want? Use it as a motivation, as an inspiration, so that over time, you can save for it, and time will come that you will be victorious to finally get it. And you will be happier because it's something that did not give you a problem. The problem is, too many people are spending money they have not yet earned to buy something they actually don't need, but simply want to impress those people they don't like. If you think people are looking at your phone, no, because they have their own problems to solve and they don't care about your phone. I'm the type of advocate who will tell you, go ahead and enjoy the pleasures of life, but make sure that you are within the budget. Or tip number 4 is, differentiate your asset and your liability. asset is something that gives you money and that keeps money flow in and increases your value. A liability is something that you actually spend for and will siphon your income into spendings. For example, mortgage a car and you have to spend monthly installment payments for it. You have to spend gas for it. You have to spend for its maintenance. So some of my friends who got cars thought that it's a good investment. They say it becomes an asset and realize in the end that car is not a need, but simply a want. Why did they buy the car anyway? They just want to show off that they're driving a brand new car. But people who in the streets don't even care. So the next time you buy something of value, make sure that it is an asset and it's not gonna be your liability. Number 5, differentiate your savings from your investment. If you tell me that you have money in your savings account, that savings, that is not an investment. Why? It's not earning you money. Investment refers to this portfolio that you may get into where money earns money. But if it's something for your savings, it's okay. In fact, the advocacy is that you should be able to save money enough for you to sustain your life without income for at least 3 months. And I repeat that. The rule of thumb is that you should be able to have savings that will be sufficient to run your life without income for at least 3 months. That could form part of your emergency fund, which can give you peace of mind as you work every day, that you're comfortable that if anything happens, you have your money. I have advice for those people who enter into business for money. Please don't. The fact is, you may not be able to earn that money before you give up. Tip number 6 will again differentiate the rich and the poor. You know, the rich people will have this formula. Income minus savings equals expense. The intention of this video is to provide you some alternative mindsets. Just keep your mind open into some possibilities of implementing some simple solutions so that your life becomes better every day. Of course, it is easier for the rich to be able to deduct their savings from their income and limit their expenses with what is left. But isn't it more wise for the poor to be able to save a little, no matter how small, so that they can accumulate it over time, so that they can use it to improve their lives by using it as capital for business or capital for investment? There should be no excuse if number 1 in your list is savings. Since this is all about mindset, think about why you always prioritize your electricity bill amongst your payables. It's not because you can stand the night without electricity, but it is because you don't want the humiliation that your neighbors would know that you were not able to pay your electricity, isn't it? Now again, we are concerned about how other people would think about our lives, but we tend to forget what really matters. So think about your savings like an electricity bill that should be prioritized no matter how small, because little accumulated amount will become big sooner before you know it. Tip number 8 has something to do with debts. You must have met a person who has a problem with credit cards. You know, the credit cards will be a very tempting tool in your wallet that could make you spend for what you want rather than on what you need. I have nothing against credit card. I have it myself. But if you don't limit credit cards' use only to what you need and start spending on what you want before you even have the money to pay for it, you may be drowned by the interest rates that it will impose. And before you know it, you will reach your credit limit beyond your capability to pay. Then you will get legal demands, and then you will be bothered, then your productivity for work will be affected. And you will suffer psychologically and, of course, financially. Be careful about debts. In fact, debts are good if you will use the resources to create more money. like many businesses, even the biggest business people will borrow money from other people so that they can finance their new ventures. And therefore, they can earn more than the interest they have to pay for. But how many people will actually borrow from other people, not for what they need, but for what they want? Tip number 9, never spend money that you have not yet earned. Don't even think about how to spend the money that are yet to come. That's the problem of many people. For example, in December, their 13th month pay will be anticipated as early as November, that before the 13th month pay is paid by the employer, it has already been spent. Number 10 is something I should never miss. Make sure that your money is able to contribute to the betterment of a person or of the society. Don't forget to look for your nearest charity project or your church or people who might need your help. In that way, you can find greater meaning to the money that you work hard for. And indeed, there is a supernatural, gracious God who will continue to reward our good acts. Start by working not for the money. Work for what you love to do. Working for the money is like playing tennis with your eyes on the scoreboard. You will lose the game. The best way is to play tennis with your eyes on the ball, and the scoreboard is just an indicator of how good you play the game. If you work for the money, you may just end up sad because it's not enough to make you happy. But if you work for what you love to do, there's not gonna be a single day in your life that you have to work. And you'll be surprised that money will just pour in and come in because it becomes secondary. And if you have a dream, you just have to make a decision to design your life so that every day becomes a stepping stone to make it better. If soon you will meet a person who will claim that he or she is poor, you better validate and educate that person that being rich or poor is not about how much money one has or lacks. It's about how they think about their lives and how they use this money around them to make a difference.
This video is brought to us by
CBRC Tanay, CBRC Tugagaraw, CBRC Nueva Ecija, CBRC Occidental Mindoro, CBRC Palawan, CBRC Digos, CBRC Bacolod, CBRC Rojas, CBRC General Santos, CBRC Ozamas.